Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. In the last episode, we made our way into Drummond Island, discovered the Pacific P-16, and completed two of the bridge building tasks. We haven't yet discovered any of the watchtowers for Drummond Island, so let's switch back to the Chevy and make a start on those. Just past the watchtower in the southwest corner of the map is the off-road gearbox upgrade. On the Drummond Island map, there are still some watchtowers to discover and missions which are best completed in a scout vehicle. But for tasks such as mud wrestling and Silent Observer, there is a real risk of tipping over in sections with no winch points. As we currently only have the P-16 as a recovery vehicle, which simply will not fit down some of the paths we need to take for those missions, I'll leave those tasks for now and we'll head into Island Lake. The Island Lake map has no fuel station, but thankfully there are several fuel trailers which we can use to fill up for free. Following this path will lead us to a watchtower, then we can head up the hill to discover the raised suspension upgrade for the Chevy Kodiak. is a Kodiak we can rescue and add to our fleet, back on the Black River map. Heading back past the fuel carrier, we'll need to cross some swampy sections to explore the northern part of the island lake map. There are a few more watchtowers we can discover along the way. There is a scout fuel carrier not too far up this road, which I was considering picking up for the next task, but we won't actually need it for now. We now get to the main reason for being here, the Western Star Twin Steer. Completing the No Country for Old Truck task will add this vehicle to our fleet. I'm going to swap back to the P16 and bring it to Island Lake to help us complete this task. There are a few different options for fixing up the twin steer. We need to fully repair and refuel it, and luckily everything we need to complete the task exists on this map. We could have picked up the scout fuel carrier we passed earlier, but the P16 has less trouble dragging the regular fuel trailer through the mud than the Chevy does with the scout trailer. I'll leave the fuel trailer for now. It's not far from this logging station. It's a service trailer we can use to repair the twin steer. This is an example of where the P16 really shines, as it can manage towing both the service trailer and can winch along the fuel trailer at the same time. We'll need to use 608 repair points to fully repair the twin steer. While I have the service trailer connected, I'll also repair the single point of damage on the Chevy. With the twin steer fully fueled, it's now joined our fleet and we've been promoted to rank 6. The Western Star Twin Steer is somewhat unique, being the only vehicle capable of carrying 4 slots of cargo without a trailer, but it's not particularly versatile with nowhere to add attachments such as a crane or saddle. It also needs a few upgrades to perform well off-road, and those can only be found on later maps. For now though, let's just see if we can get it back to the Smithfield Dam Garage. We made it back to the garage, and while I don't have any plans to use the twin steer for any missions in the near future, I won't just sell it without good reason. I'll leave it there for this episode. Thanks for watching.